has brought you.
Receive my praise, O God.
Receive, Lord. Receive my praise. Receive my praise, Lord.
There is somebody, it's better for you to look back and see how far God has brought you from. The psalmist David said, he took me from the miry clay and he set my feet upon the rock to stay. Don't just see where you are now, see where he brought you from. You will know that there is a reason for you to give him glory. I don't know about you, but I know where he brought me from. I was a nobody. I was a non-entity. People don't even like me. There was nothing too good around my life. But yet, this God had so much in store for my life. See where I am today by the grace of God. I don't know about you, I'm talking about myself. If you want to join me in appreciating God for my life, I don't know if you have a reason, raise your voice and give him all the glory.
Receive, Lord. Receive my praise. Receive my praise, Lord.
For the gift of salvation.
Receive, oh, receive, Lord. Receive my praise. Receive my
for protection and preservation.
Receive my praise, O Lord. Receive, Lord. Receive my praise. Receive my praise, Lord.
Daddy, we have come to say thank you. We are so grateful to you for what we are today. If not for God who had been on our side, many people concluded on us and they said to us that we are but nothing. They called us nobodies, but see what we are today. Thank you for bringing us thus far. And we know that you who had begun the good work in us, you are faithful to complete it. Finish your good work in our lives. Many of us are still in the process of making. Make us to what you want us to be. Give our lives relevance. Give our lives relevance. That people will have no choice but to acknowledge us. Make us relevant in our generation. In the name of Jesus. May God make you relevant in your family in the name of Jesus. Take us to heights that we never dreamt of. Take us to places that we never knew we'd ever get to. And let Jesus be glorified. Thank you for today. Thank you for that which you will do. Thank you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Bless us abundantly, Lord. Bless us abundantly. Bless us abundantly. Thank you, Father, for everything. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Take your seats quietly. God bless you this morning. We want to bless God for another day, another time to be in the presence of God. We want to appreciate God for his grace and his goodness upon our lives. We know that God has been faithful to us. As a ministry, we are grateful to God for that which he's doing for us. As an individual, I am grateful to God. And I believe I should be grateful to God also for your life. The very fact that you are connecting with us, it is a testimony on its own. I want to thank God for your life. Because irrespective of this coronavirus that is going around, your name is not among the dead. And for that alone, we must be grateful to God. And I know that to the end of this virus, you will still be alive in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I want to pray one more time that none of your family members will be a victim of coronavirus in Jesus' name. at the end of it all, you will still be able to gather all, and none will be missing around you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to share God's word this morning. And I believe that the word of God that is coming this morning is coming for somebody. I want to be grateful to God. I overheard Pastor John when he was praying this morning. And he said something that I was jumping in the office. I leaped for joy. He said that one thing you must desire when you come to a service is for a word, a word, a word. It will take a word to cause a change in your life. You don't need a message. You need a word. You need a word. You need a word. Hannah had been going to the temple for several years, but the word that will bring her testimony was not yet released. That fateful day that Eli met her, and Eli looked at a woman that was in pain, a woman that was in travail, and the servant of God looked at that woman, and the servant of God said to her that by this time next year, that was enough to settle the matter. That was enough. She was not in need of a sermon. She was in need of a proclamation that will come from the servant of God's mouth. I come as the Eli of this house today. I don't know what is that concern of yours. I don't know what is that issue you are trusting God to do. As Eli said to Anna, I prophesy to your life that as it happened to Anna, may the same happen for you in Jesus' name. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that by this time next year, you will be a missus in Jesus' name. Oh, I say by this time next year, your level will have changed in the name of Jesus. By this time next year, academically, you'll move to another dimension in Jesus' name. By this time next year, in business, you will be catapulted to a higher dimension in the name of Jesus. By this time next year, whatever is your concern, whatever it is you are trusting God for, is it settlement? Is it childbearing? Is it marriage? I don't know what. Is it traveling? I pray for you like Eli prayed for Hannah. By this time next year, may God settle your matter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Heaven will respond to your prayers.
Amen.
And heaven will give you a testimony.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be for you this morning in Jesus' name. Take your seat. Take your seat. We want to receive God's word. We want to receive God's word. And I want to encourage you to stay connected, because the word that is coming this morning is coming for somebody. I want to minister on the subject I titled, Binding the Strong Man and Demanding Your Freedom. Binding the Strong Man and Demanding Your Freedom. Binding the strong man and demanding your freedom. Father, bless your word, bless your people today. From near and afar, wherever they are, let your word reach them and let your word cause a change in them. Let your word bring forth their testimony. Your word that is quick and powerful, your word that is sharper than any two-edged sword, let it pierce through their hearts. Let it cause a dividing in their mind and in their soul, and let Jesus be glorified. Thank you, because it is done. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Binding the strong man and demanding your freedom. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be quick this morning by saying that every freedom comes with a cost. Every freedom comes with a cost. Nobody becomes free without paying a price. Nobody in life becomes free without paying a price. You see, when Israel was in captivity, they had to work for 400 years under hard labor. They had to suffer in the hands of Pharaoh for 400 years under hard labor. When God told Moses and the people of Israel, God said to them, I have given you the land. Go and possess it. Listen to me. They did went and possess it, but it came with a cost. What was the cost? There were enemies to confront and conquer. Even though God said, I gave the land to you, but there was a cost. So hear me. If you must be free, you must be ready for battle. If you must be free, you must be ready for battle. When God wanted to save the world, it came with a cost.
What was the cost? He sent his only son to come and die on the cross in order for man to be saved. Listen to me and listen well. Any freedom without a cost is not guaranteed. Any freedom without a cost is not guaranteed. Therefore, if you must be free, you must demand it in prayer. If you must be free, if your family must be free, you must desire and demand it in prayer. And therefore, I want you to rise on your feet and let's pray three prayers before we go deep to the word of God. If you must be free, you must demand your freedom in prayer. Rise up on your feet and pray these three prayers with me. You are going to raise your voice. And number one prayer, say, my Father, my God. Say, my Father, my fighter. As I pray this morning, every strong man that is holding me ransom, every strong man that is holding my family ransom, as I pray this morning, I demand my release by the blood of Jesus. I demand my release by the blood of Jesus. I demand my release in the name of Jesus. I demand my release. I demand my release. I demand my release. I demand my release in the name of Jesus. I demand my release. Every strong man holding me ransom, as I pray this morning, I demand my release by the blood, by the blood, by the blood. I demand my release. Every strong man holding me ransom, holding my family ransom, as I pray this morning, I demand my release. 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 Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Pray the second prayer well. I repeat again. If you must be free, you must demand it in prayer. Prayer point number two. Say, my God, my Father.
My Father, my Fighter.
As I pray today, every strong man holding my family in captivity by reason of the blood of Jesus, we bind you in Jesus' name. Every strong man holding my family in captivity by reason of the blood of Jesus, we bind you in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and make that your prayer. Iga basho tala mandeke. Every strong man holding my family in captivity. Every strong man holding my family in captivity by reason of the blood. By reason of the blood, 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 we bind you, 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 by reason of the blood of Jesus, we bind you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
One more prayer, and we go shortly to the word, and we enter prayer again. Today's service is more of prayer. Prayer point number three. Lift up your voice. Say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very strong. My Father, my Fighter.
My Father, my Father.
As I pray this morning, every strong man resisting the progress of my life, every strong man resisting the progress of my family, what are you waiting for? Give up now in the name of Jesus. Every strong man resisting the progress of my life, resisting the progress of my family, what are you waiting for? Give up now. 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 Je katora badagana. Je de 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 de. Je de de de. Je de de de. Je de de de. Je kapo. Ikata. Ikopo. Jipokata. Igetete. Jibreka sokoto. What are you waiting for? Give up now. Give up now. Give up now. Give up now. Je
Give up now in the name of Jesus. Give up now in the name of Jesus. Every strong man.
Jesus, mighty name, we pray. Take your seat for a while. Isaiah 49, verses 24 unto 26. Isaiah 49, verse number 24 unto 26. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? But thus saith the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. For I will contend with him that contendeth with thee, and I will save their children. Look at the end part of verse 26. He said, and I will feed them that oppress thee with their own flesh, and they shall be drunken with their own blood as with sweet wine. Who is a strong man? Who is a strong man? I want to show you who is a strong man and how you will know that a strong man is after your life. Who is a strong man? Number one. A strong man is a satanic spiritual authority assigned to rule and control. A strong man is a satanic spiritual authority assigned to rule and control. Number two, who is a strong man? I give you them quick. Who is a strong man? Number two, a strong man is a spiritual dictator. A strong man is a spiritual dictator. They determine what happens to you. A strong man is a spiritual dictator. They determine what happens to you. Number three, who is a strong man? Number three, a strong man is the contender of destiny. A strong man is the contender of destiny. Strong man will always go after people that carries destiny. If your life is a non-entity, a strong man will not bother you. But when your life has great destiny, a strong man will be assigned to contend. They will not succeed over your life in Jesus' name. They will not succeed over your destiny in Jesus' name. The contender of destiny. Number four, who is a strong man? A strong man is a vision killer. A strong man is a what? Is a vision killer. They kill the visions of people. When you have a dream, when you have a vision that will make your life relevant, the duty of a strong man is to kill that vision. I don't know what is that vision that God gave to you long ago. There is somebody watching at me. Many years ago, God told you about you helping young children. And that vision has been burning in your heart. And all of a sudden, sometimes you feel like it is not important. Listen to me. It is a vision from God. And if only you can concentrate and be ready to make the sacrifice, the result and the benefit will be great. A strong man is a vision killer. Number five, finally, who is a strong man? A strong man is an oppressor assigned to make life bitter and miserable for you. A strong man is an oppressor that is assigned to make life bitter and miserable. Life is meant to be better, not bitter. But very unfortunate that many people's lives, instead of it becoming better, it is becoming bitter. Every bitterness in your life, I turn it to be better in the name of Jesus. Amen. I say every bitterness in your life, from today, let your life be better in the name of Jesus. An oppressor that is on assignment to make life bitter for you. From today, your life will not be bitter again.
Yeah.
Somebody didn't hear me. I said, from today, your life will cease to be bitter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So these are the way you know that this is the strong man. How do you know that you are under the influence of a strong man? I'm rushing because I have a lot to do. How do you know that you are under the influence of a strong man? Somebody is watching at me now and you are wondering, say, but am I part of what pastor is talking about? Am I part of they that are under the influence of a strong man? This is how you know. If you fall in any of this category, then when we are praying today, you need to pray more than me, the pastor. When we are praying today, you need to pray more than the person that is next to you. Because it is very clear that many people living in church, they are under the influences of strong men. Number one, how do you know that you are under the influence of a strong man? Number one, whenever you notice that your life is going the direction you don't like, but you cannot control it, you are under the influence of a strong man. Whenever you notice that your life is going in a direction you don't like it, but yet you can't control it. You hate what you do, but you keep doing it. My sister, your life is under the influence of a strong man. There are some sins you commit, you don't like them, but you keep committing it. There are some things you keep doing. You hate doing it, but you keep finding yourself doing it. It is a sign that a strong man, that cord of sin over your life is broken in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that cord of sin is broken over your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number two, how do you know that your life is under the influence of a strong man? Number two, if you are working or you are in business, but yet your life is miserable. My brother, a strong man is after your life. Anytime you see you are giving an input, you are doing something that makes life easy, but yet you are miserable. There are some people, they wake up in the morning and they go to work every day. At the end of the month, their life is full of debts. They have many debts on their head. There are some people, every morning they will wake up and go to the market and go to their business place, and they will not come till late in the night, and at the end of the business it will be full of losses. Your life is under the influence of a strong man, because according to my scripture, according to God's word, according to the scripture, the Bible said, God said that he will bless the works of your hand. So why must you be working and there is no blessing? Why must you be engaged in a business and there is no result for your business? It is a sign that a strong man. There is somebody watching at me that is into business.
Yes,
it is a small business now, but it is not going the way you desire it to go.
Yes,
from today, that business will begin to prosper in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said that your business will begin to prosper in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number three. How do you know that you are under the influence of a strong man? Number three. When people see you as a star, you know you have the seed of greatness in you, but yet nothing is working for you.
Yeah.
I repeat. When people see you, they see you as a star. You yourself, you know that you carry something. You know that there is greatness all around you, but vividly, nothing is working for you. People, they call you, but you, they sorry for yourself. A strong man is after your life. People see you, they say, this guy is a great guy, eh? That was what happened to Gideon. Gideon was at the backside of the bush. Gideon was taking care of the field. He was planting, doing all manner of things for survival. Yet, the angel came and said to him, thou mighty man of valor. Hey, Gideon paused and said, I think you are talking to the wrong person. You call me mighty? That's what is happening to many of you watching at me. People call you big names, but your life is empty. People see you, they feel all is well for you, but in your quiet moment you are full of tears. It is a sign that your life is under the influence of a strong man. So that you will end up becoming a mockery. You are in the same job with your mates. They are making things. They are making money. Things are working for them. But for you, nothing is coming out of your job. It is a sign that a strong man. I pray for 14 people that is watching at me. Every influence of the strong man over your destiny.
Yes,
every influence of the strong man over your family.
Yes,
every influence of the strong man over your life.
Yes,
I break it in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
I break it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
People see you as a star. They say you are great. They say you are a great man of God. But when you look at your life, you don't even have a good place to sleep. But they say you are anointed. Very anointed. Yet there is no food on your plate. You are very, very, you know you are called by God. You are really called. You are called by Him. No. It's nobody called you. God calls you. But yet there is no result. I've met people like that, sir. I've met many pastors, men of God like that. When you invite them to your church, they will manifest power. You will admire them. If you invite them around you, when they are done with the ministration, you will want to be like them. You desire some of the good things that they carry, but follow them to where they are. There is no single result under them. It is a sign that your life is under the influence of a strong man. I don't know who I am talking to today. I don't know which area that strong man has influenced you negatively. But you are breaking out of that cage in Jesus' name. I say you are breaking out of that cage in Jesus' mighty name. Number four. How do you know that you are under the influence of a strong man? Number four. You have good visions and dreams for your life and destiny. But none of them is working. You have very good visions and dreams for your life and your destiny. But none of those dreams are working for you. Hear this now. I've met people, sir. They have good ideas in business. They will tell people on how to make money in business. People will try it and they succeed. But if they do, nothing will come out of it. They will share with you good ideas on how to make money. And when you try it, it will work. But for them, it will never work. Good visions and dreams for your destiny. You have tried all of them. None of them is working. My sister, it is a sign that a strong man is after your life. A strong man has been assigned to mess up with your destiny. I used to know a man of God. I think I shared this one day in church here. I used to know a man of God. This man of God, when I say a reader, the man is a reader. The man is heavy. The man has revelation. That is a close person to me. That man carries something. If he stand to teach, even you, the pastor, you'll be a student under him. When you go around this man, there is no result, no proof. Make case worse. One day he decided to start making a daily devotional. Daily devotional. He wrote a yearly daily devotional. After all the time he spent writing the devotional, he finished now. There was nobody to buy. So he went to a pastor and was sharing it. He said, "Pastor, I have something that I did, a daily devotional." He said, "But I don't have members in my church." He said, "Look at it." And the pastor said, "Okay, well, if you don't have members, give it to me so that I can just do something." And he said, "No, no problem, Pastor." And he handed over the daily devotional to this other pastor. And the pastor went and printed the daily devotional under his name and came to his church. And the pastor made about 24 million profits. After 1 month, he met the pastor. And the pastor was saying to him, "How was it?" He said, "My brother, I made a lot of money." He said, "Really?" He said, "I made over 20 million in that devotional." He said, "What about me?" He said, "Which you?" The pastor gave him nothing. He came to me, he was complaining. His ideas was used by somebody else to the profit of the person. But for him, nothing good is coming out of his life. It is a sign that that pastor is under the influence of a strong man. You can carry all the ideas to be great. You can have all the principles to success. Hear this now. You can have all the keys to break through. They will tell you all the stages you have to cross to successful marriage. But go and check their home. They teach you all the principles to have a good family. But their homes are scattered. They have it in their head, but the spirit is not connected. Can I pray for somebody that is watching at me? From today, your effort will not be wasted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say from today, your ideas will bless your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
People will not use you for their own benefit in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May you not be a used instrument in the hands of people in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There are many people like that. They are just being used by others. They can be in the office. Watch me now. They will be the one bringing all the ideas for that business or office to succeed. But yet, they are the least paid in the office. And those who can't even put two and four together, they will be the general managers and the directors. And those who are laboring well, those who are bringing ideas for things to work. In fact, somebody came to me the other day, and the person was crying to me. He said that in my own problem, I've been to many, many different institutions. He said, all the institutions I've been to, he said, we started it together. He said, the sooner things begin to work, they will fire me. He said, and when we start, I will be the one that will be showing them what and what they have to do in order for the institution to succeed. He said, the sooner the institution will take a footing, they will just kick me out. It is a sign that a strong man is after your life. I want to beg you to join me to pray this morning. I want to beg you to join me to pray this morning that your case will not be like somebody that have good visions, somebody that have good dreams for your own life and destiny, but none of those dreams are visions will be working for. Isaiah 49, the scripture we just read, verse 24, it says, God said that he will contend with them that contend with you. He will feed them with their own flesh, and he will cause them to be drunken with their own wine. Rise up on your feet wherever you are. We are here to wage war. We are here to wage war. Every power from your foundation that says your life will be useless, those powers are in trouble this morning.
Amen.
Every wicked power that says you walk like an elephant and eat like an ant, those powers, they will crumble before you this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any power from your foundation that is making mockery of that which God has put in your life.
Yes.
Bible said that the gift of a man maketh room for him. The gift of a man will cause him to stand before kings and not ordinary mere men. But when a strong man is after your life, you carry the gift, and yet you will not be relevant. I want to beg you to pray. I want to beg you to pray. I want to beg you to pray. This morning, I want to encourage you to pray these few prayers. Pray them well. And as you do, I see God bringing a change. I see a shift taking place in the life of somebody in Jesus' name. Lift up your hand wherever you are. Lift up your hand and say, Lord, I thank you.
Lord,
come on, just thank him. Just thank him for this wonderful
Lord, I thank you for
give him praise. 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 Give him praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give him glory. Give him honor.
Thank you for your
words. Leba shota lamada. Leba shota lamanta kama. Give him all the honor.
You
we glorify you, we magnify
you. Are great. You
let
are
your great. Name be glorified. Let your name be magnified. Labasho labadoro musete. Ibo shola manta lamandi dedebiya. Yeda da da basata da basata ya bakushoto. Lebudoro bushi dedebe dedebe shi dedebiya. Labashota ya. Labasho lamandi ba 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 ba. Thank you for your word this morning. Thank you. Come on, somebody. Thank you for his word. Thank you for your deliverance upon my life this morning. Thank you because your word will set me free. Your word will set me free.
Thank you, Father.
Your word will set me free. Your word will make me relevant. Your word will give me the result that I desire this morning.
Thank you for your word, Holy Ghost.
Yahweh, come and do what only you. Mighty man of war, mighty man of war, Lion of Judah, we bow down and worship you. Yahweh, come and do what only mighty man of war,
Lion of Judah,
we bow down and worship you, Yahweh, come and do what only you, mighty man of war,
Lion of Judah,
we bow down and worship you, Yahweh, come and do what only you.
Two more time.
Mighty man of war,
Lion of Judah,
we bow down and worship you. Sing Yahweh, come and do what's on you.
One more time.
Mighty man of war,
Lion of Judah,
we bow down and worship you, Yahweh, come and do what only you can do.
Four prayers we are going to pray this morning. And like I said earlier on, if only you would join me to pray them well.
Yes, sir.
After this day, you will begin to notice that something has changed in your life.
Amen.
I beg you to pray it well. Forget about the person that is next to you.
Sure.
As you have heard the word of God, you know exactly your state and your condition.
Yes, sir.
I've met people like that people admire, but they are miserable.
Mm.
That's what is happening to many of you. People admire you, but you know you are miserable. And hear this, you can fool any man, but you can't fool yourself. Because you know your true state and condition. So when we say pray, it is not for us, it is for your good. I want you to join me and pray. Lift up your hand and pray. And say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very loud, say, my Father, my God. As I pray this morning,
every strong man
eating the virtue of my life,
every strong man
eating the virtue of my family,
vomit
it by fire.
Eating the virtue of my family.
Eating the fatty of my life, eating the fatty of my family. Let them vomit it today. 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 Let them vomit it. Prayer point number two. Lift up your hand and say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very strong. Say, my Father, my God.
My Father, my God.
As I pray this morning.
As I pray this morning.
Every spell.
Every spell.
Working against my life.
Working against my life.
Every spell.
Every spell.
Working against my destiny.
Working against my destiny.
We render you powerless.
We render you powerless.
By the blood of Jesus. Lift up your voice and fire that
word.
Every spell. Working against my life and destiny. By the blood of Jesus, we Say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father.
Very loud, my Father, my God.
My Father, my God.
As I pray this morning,
as I pray this morning,
every strong man,
every strong
controlling
controlling my life,
controlling my
every strong man,
controlling my
destiny.
As
I pray today,
I
overthrow you by the blood of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
This is the last prayer for this morning. And like I always encourage you, even if you have prayed it now, I encourage you to pray it again.
Yes, sir.
Bible says faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word. You keep doing it again and again. What you keep here is what you become.
Yes.
So when you pray prayers like this, let it not end where you are now. After we are done, when you have your leisure time, pray again.
Yes.
If you must be free, you must buy your freedom in prayer.
Yeah.
Very last prayer point for this morning. Lift up your hand and pray with me. Say, my God, my Father.
My God, my Father, my Fighter.
As I pray this morning, every curse,
every incantation
issued against my life,
issued against my family,
by any strong man.
As I pray this morning,
I render you powerless. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray that
every spell, every incantation,
issued against my life,
issued against my family,
by any strong man, I render you useless and powerless. In the name of Jesus,
out of my heart,
I render you useless because of the Lord.
Thank you, Father. Stretch your hand. Stretch your hand before the altar wherever you are. Stretch your hand before you. Stretch your hand before you wherever you are. Close your eyes. Every spell, every curse, every incantation. Oh, that is issued against your life. I don't know what they said. Some of you, they said you will never settle down in life. You will never get married. Hey, that's what they said. But that's their own. Whose report will you believe? We choose to believe the report of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
I have come with the report of Jehovah. That spell of marital stagnation is canceled in Jesus' name. Oh, that spell of marital instability is canceled in Jesus' name. Stretch your hand before you. I don't know what they said about your life.
Yes, sir.
They say you don't live long. That's their report. But I come with the report of Jehovah.
Yes.
That says with long life will I satisfy you. And I will show you my salvation.
Yes.
Every spell of untimely death.
Yes.
Every curse of untimely death.
Uh-huh.
Every incantation of untimely death.
Uh-huh.
Is broken over your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall live long in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You shall fulfill your days in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You shall fulfill your years in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Labashota, lama. Stretch your hand before you. Every spell of backwardness.
Yes.
There are 14 people watching at me. The spell of backwardness is very clear over your family. Over your family. When you watch your family, when you watch your background, you know that, we now would never work for people. I pray for you today.
Yes.
That spell of backwardness is canceled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that spell of limitation and backwardness
is
canceled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That spell of poverty
yes.
is canceled in the name of Jesus. Stretch your hand before you. Lebosakata. Alabasa. There are four people watching at me now. Three ladies and a man.
Uh-huh.
Three ladies and a man.
Uh-huh.
I hear there is a spell of starting well but ending bad.
Mm-hmm.
A spell that is in your family. You people will start well, but they will end miserably.
Uh-huh.
That spell over your life. If I be a man of God, if I be a servant of God,
yes,
I pray for you today.
I receive
that spell of starting well and ending badly.
Yes,
I break it over your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I break it over your destiny in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I reject it over your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will end well in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say you will end well in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say you will not end like others in the family in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your curse will be different in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Labasota lamata tata lamanteka iko kalabadika na baya baba. Jidedede mezi mezi kasakata. Alalamanto kaya bazoto. Ledododobo se ya labasata.
Yes Lord.
I feel the presence of God in the life of somebody. Where you are holding the phone, the presence of God is all over you. It's all over you. It's all over you now. Krebo siya ikatoya manda. Power is coming upon you.
Yes.
Alabazoto. Every strong man that is on assignment to mess up with your destiny. Every strong man that's on assignment to make your life useless. Every strong man that's on assignment to waste your life.
Yes,
to make you small.
Uh-huh.
I come as an oracle of Jehovah.
Uh-huh.
I come as a mouthpiece of heaven.
Mm-hmm.
I pray over your life.
Uh-huh.
I pray over your destiny. From today, I command that strong man to live your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Live your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Live your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From today, you shall walk in total liberty.
Yeah.
You shall walk in complete freedom.
Yeah.
For he that the Son has set free
yes.
is free indeed. Your liberty and your freedom
you begin to enjoy it from today.
Amen.
You begin to experience it from today.
Amen.
You begin to walk in it from today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be for you.
Amen.
Lift up your voice and begin to bless him. Somebody,
thank you, Father.
Bless him, bless him, bless him.
Thank you, Father.
Bless him and give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise.
Amen.
Give him praise.
You,
give him glory.
We glorify you. Thank you.
Give him praise. 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 Alabashota. Lebosia Lamata Baba Sotuna.
Way maker.
Miwa kubwa. Promise kila. Light in my darkness. My God. That is.
To somebody, light has come over your darkness. Light has come over your darkness. Light has come over your darkness. Every darkness upon your life, the light of God has come upon it in Jesus' name. And when light comes, darkness has no choice but to disappear. Light has come over your life. Light has come over your destiny. Light has come over your family. Light has come over all that concerns you. From today, you will enjoy the light of God. Oh, I said from today, you will enjoy the light of God. Every darkness will disappear in Jesus' name. We command every darkness and gross darkness.
Yes.
Let them vanish over your lives in Jesus' name. May you walk in the light of God. May you walk in the light of God. May you walk in the light of God. May you walk in the light of God in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for what you have done. We are grateful today, Father. Thank you for your word that we receive.
Thank you.
We ask that all of us will begin to walk in that light. Oh, we begin to walk in the light. You said in your word that you are the light of the world. And anyone that walks with you will not grope in darkness. Therefore, may we begin to walk in your light from today. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for your light.
Thank you
for your light. Be glorified. Bless your people abundantly. Let these prayers work for them. Let these prayers be answered for them. Let these prayers cause a change in them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Receive all the glory. Receive all the praise. Receive all the honor and adoration. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Take your seat. The Lord bless you. We are done for today. God bless you. We want to thank God for your life.
I believe you have been blessed. Tomorrow again, we'll be here for the deliverance session at 6:30 in the evening. Tomorrow evening again, we'll be here for our deliverance session at 6:30. We encourage you to keep joining us. Keep joining us. And as I was ministering just now, I hear God saying to my spirit that there is somebody watching at me. You need to invite others to be enjoying what you are enjoying. Make sure you connect this page to your friends and loved ones. Connect them. Tell them to watch. Send the videos to them. Send the YouTube videos to them. Send it to them. Allow people also to be blessed. Don't be selfish with the blessings of God. It is so much that nobody can collect your portion. It is so much enough that everybody can have is their own portion, and yet they are remaining. When Jesus blessed the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes, after feeding all, there were still 12 baskets remaining. The blessings of God, don't be selfish with it. It is so much that even after all of us will receive our own portion, there will be too many that will still be left. So please, encourage somebody, and the Lord will mightily bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We want to encourage you to connect with us again tomorrow evening, 6:30, and the Lord will mightily bless you. God bless you, all of you who are supporting this ministry in cash and in kind. There are some of you who are supporting us from wherever you are. We appreciate God for your life. Those of you who supported the window project, we thank God for you. As at yesterday, there were only 13 windows left. Out of the 42, there were only 13 windows left as at yesterday. So we still continue to encourage others to be part of it. We pray that as you support God's work, God will support your life. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord give you his peace. Your going out and your coming in shall be blessed. In the name of Jesus. From today, you will walk in the light of Jehovah. Things will begin to work positively for you. In the name of Jehovah. Wherever you go, you will be favored by men. As Jesus found favor before man and God, so it will be for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will find favor before men as you have found favor with God. In the name of Jesus. The light of God will take you to your place of blessing.
Amen.
The light of God will take you to your place of breakthrough.
Amen.
The light of God will take you to your place of favor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Where your destiny helpers are, that is where the light of God will carry you to in Jesus' name. You will not go to the wrong place in life. You will be in the right place at the right time. And the blessings of God will not be eluded you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for all you have done. Bless us abundantly. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Shalom.